Namaste friends, welcome back to my channel. Friends, in my series of jewelry pieces with 3D beauty shapes, here I am introducing to you my second earring that I have named as Blossom Earring. It just looked like a flower on a branch of a plant and I have named it as Blossom Earring. And here I have made this earring in two lengths. This is the longer one. You can see the size of this earring, and one more I have made in the smaller size. You can see the size. You can see the two sizes. That I have made in this earring, this blossom earring. If you are fond of wearing long earrings or long danglers, this would be up for you. And if you love wearing the smaller earrings, this will work for you. So I have made this in two sizes and in different colorways. This one is in amethyst color with this beautiful green contrast. Then this I have made the smaller size in light pink and the fuchsia color. You can see the look. And one more colorways in the smaller size, I have made this in blue and topaz color. And in today's video, we are going to make the longer earring, the longer dangler in this sea green and amethyst contrast. And in today's video, we are going to make this beautiful blossom earring in this sea green and amethyst contrast. So let us see what all material do we need to make this blossom earring. Friends, for making our blossom earring in green color, we would need these 11 O's. These are Mukki Aqua Green Ceylon 11 O's. Then I'm using this 11 O again in green color, but these are in metallic color. These are metallic dark green iris 11 O's. Here I'm using these Mukki Duracoat Galvanized Silver 11 O's, and these are 15 O's in the same color, that is Mukki Duracoat Galvanized Silver 15 O's. Then I'm using these drop beads of size 10 by 7 mm. You can also use bralettes if you don't have these drop beads. These are in emerald green color. I'll be using these 10 mm Rivoli crystal in emerald green color, 4 mm bicons in amethyst color, and 3 mm pearls in burgundy color. Here I'm using these ear hooks. These are lever back ear hooks in silver color. Here I'm working with Mukki thread and size 12 beading needle. So let's get started. Friends, our blossom earring has three parts. One is this upper component, that Rivoli bezel, and then we have these Pioté V's that we have made using Pioté stitch. So here we are going to start making our blossom earring by first making that Rivoli component on the top. So for making our Rivoli component, we are going to bezel our 10 mm Rivoli crystal using raw stitch. For making the bezel case with raw stitch, here I have picked up 4 11 O aqua green. And now I'm bringing them down towards the end of my thread and tying a double knot. Like this. And here this is my first raw unit, and now I'm going to pass through all these four 11 O's, pulling in the tail in between these beads. And into this first 11 O, like this. So this is our first right angle weave unit, and now I'm going to make my second row unit. So I'm picking up 3 11 0s because this is my fourth 11 0, and as you can see, I'm exiting to the top of this 11 0. I'm going to pass through the bottom, and this will make my second right angle weave unit. Now into the 11 0 on the top and into the 11 0 on the side. So here we have made 2 units, and now I'm going to make my third unit. So again, I'm picking up these 3 11 0s, and when I'm exiting through the bottom of this 11 0, I'm going to pass through the top of the same 11 0 like this. So this is my third row unit into the 11 0. If you pass through 11 0s one at a time, you will get a nice shape like this. Just keep your thread nice and tight here. So here is the look. We have these 3 row units, and now I'm going to make my fourth unit. So again, I have picked up 3 11 0s, and when I'm exiting from the top, I'm going to pass through the bottom of this 11 0 like this, and moving up and into the 11 0 at the side. So here you can see I have added 1, 2, 3, 4 right angle weave units in my chain, and for bezeling a 10 mm Rivoli crystal, we need 12 raw units in our bezel ring. So here I'm going to make a chain with 11 units, and 12th would be the one which will join the two ends of this chain. So here I have made 1, 2, 3 and 4 units. I'll be adding 7 more and come back. So here I have made my chain with 11 raw units. Let us count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 and 11. And now we are going to make a ring by joining the two ends of the chain, bringing it closer like this. And now I'm going to pick up 1 11 0. So for this 12th unit, you can see we have 2 11 0s already. We are going to add 2 more, one on the top and one at the bottom. So here I have picked up 1 11 0 and I'm passing through the 11 0 at the other end like this. Again picking up 1 11 0 and passing through this 11 0 like this. So here we have made the ring, and now I'm stepping up into the 11 0 on the top. So this is our ring. So here this is our ring, and now we are going to add one more layer of these right angle weave units on the top of this chain. So here as I'm exiting through this 11 0, I'm picking up 3 11 0s, 1 11 0 aqua green, 1 metallic iris and 1 11 0 aqua green. Here I have added 1 11 0 metallic iris at the center, and now I'm passing through this 11 0 aqua green. Here we have to keep our thread nice and tight, and now stepping up into this 11 0 now again we have to add our second raw unit. On the top of this second raw unit at the base. So here these are the two 11-0s for our second raw unit at the top. And now you can see as I'm exiting through this 11-0, I'm going to pick up 11-0 metallic iris, green metallic green iris, because we need this metallic green iris to be on the top. So here we are moving in this direction. So I'm picking up 11-0 metallic iris first and then 11-0 aqua green. And into the 11-0, the top 11-0 of the raw unit at the base. Here you can see, again we are going to keep our thread nice and tight here. So we have got our 11-0 metallic green iris at the top, stepping up into this, into this 11-0 aqua green, and now into the third unit, so this is our third unit at the bottom. So I'm passing through this top 11-0 of the third unit, and now I'm picking up 11-0 aqua green first and 11-0 metallic green iris next, and passing through these two 11-0s like this. You can see this tail is helping me to hold the ring in place, so don't cut this before completing the bezel and into the 11-0 aqua green. Now we are moving in this direction, so we need 11-0 on the top, so we are going to pick up 11-0 first, 11-0 metallic iris first, metallic green iris first, and then aqua green, and into here. This is our next unit, so I'm passing through the top 11-0 of this next unit, stepping up into the 11-0, and into the 11-0 metallic green iris, down through this aqua green. And now this is our next 11-0, our next unit. And now I will be moving in this opposite direction. So I will pick up 11-0 aqua green first and 11-0 metallic dark green iris later. So passing through these two 11-0s, remember always our main motive is to keep this 11-0 metallic iris on the top, so we have to be very careful while adding the beads. And stepping up like this, we are going to, here you can see we have added four raw component on the top of the base raw component, and we are going to add these components all through this round. Now here you can see after adding all my units, I have reached this last one, and now stepping up into the 11-0 aqua green. Here for my last unit, my last raw unit, I already have 1, 2, 3 11-0s, so I'm going to add only one, that is this 11-0 metallic iris, metallic green iris, and into these 11-0s, stepping up into the 11-0 metallic dark green iris. So after completing this round, this is the look of our bezel ring. You can see, and right now I'm exiting through this 11O metallic dark green iris, and now I'm going to pick up 115O and pass through this next 11O metallic dark green iris, second 15O, and pass through this metallic dark green iris, and now I'm going to skip the third one. Now skipping this bead will make a corner for us. So we are skipping the third bead. Now adding fourth 15O, fifth 15O, and skipping the sixth 15O here like this. Now adding seventh 15O. Basically I'm adding the, this is the fifth 15O that I'm adding, but in the seventh place. So you can see we added here, we are following this pattern, adding two 15Os, skipping the third one, then adding two 15Os, skipping the third one. So here in this set again I'm adding one 15O, then my second 15O, and skipping the third one. Now I have reached this last set. Again I'm going to add one 15O, second 15O, and skip the third one in this last set. Like this, and now stepping up into the 15O, 11O, and 15O. So here I have stepped up into these three beads together, and here this is the space that we created, the corner. And now after passing through these three beads, I'm picking up one 11O silver, and now I'm going to pass through, skipping these two beads that we used to make the corner. I'm passing through the 15O, 11O, and the 15O, three beads. Place this like this. Now again, after passing through these three beads, I'm picking up one 11O silver and passing through these three beads, 15O, 11O, and 15O. And placing this 11O at the corner we created like this. Now again picking up one 11O silver, skipping these two beads and passing through the 15O, 11O, and the 15O. And placing this like this to make the corner here. Again picking up my last 11O silver and passing through these three 15Os and placing it here in this like this. So here you can see we have created a square shape on the top, and now after exiting through this 15O, I'm passing through this 11O metallic dark iris dark green iris into the 11-0 aqua green, down through 11-0 aqua green, into the 11-0 aqua green, and into this 11-0 aqua green. So here you can see I'm exiting through the 11-0, which is just below the corner that we created on the top. And now we are going to place our Rivoli crystal into our bezel case like this, and you can see the look from the top front here. And now let us first cut the tail off very carefully. And now we are going to close the bezel case. As I already told you that we are exiting through this 11-0, which lies just below the corner that we created on the top. So here again we are going to create the corner by skipping the bead. So we are just passing through this next 11-0, and now pick up one 11-0 aqua green. Gain one 11-0 aqua green and skip the third one. Again, pick up one 11-0 aqua green and pass through this next 11-0. One 11-0 aqua green and pass through this next 11-0 and skip the next one. And this way, we are going to complete this round by following this pattern. Adding two 11-0, skipping other, adding two 11-0, skipping the next, and complete this round. So here after completing this round, this is the look. And right now I'm exiting through this 11-0 aqua green, and now I'm stepping up into the first 11-0 that I added in this round. And now I'm going to pick up one 15-0 silver and pass through this next 11-0 aqua green. Again, picking up one 15-0 silver and pass through this next 11-0 aqua green that we added in the last round. This is the corner that we had created in the last round. So we have added this 15-0 at the corner also. Again, picking up one 15-0 silver and passing through this next 11-0 aqua green. Picking up one 15-0 silver. Passing through the 11-0 like this. Basically, we are adding these 15-0s in this round, and we are adding these at the corner also. So we would be completing this round by adding these 15-0 and come back. So here after adding my last 15-0 silver, right now I'm exiting through this 11-0 aqua green, and now I'm stepping up into the first 15-0 that I added in this round. In this round also, I'm going to add 15-0s. So I'm picking up one 15-0 silver and passing through the 15-0, the next 15-0 that we added in the last round. Again, picking up one 15-0 silver, passing through the next 15-0 silver. Again, picking up one 15-0 silver, passing through the next 15-0 silver. And this way, I'm going to add 15-0 silver all through this. And now I'm adding my last 15-0 silver. Of this round. And stepping up. Into the first 15-0 silver that I added in this round. And this is the look. After adding these 15-0s. Now here you can see we have two 15-0s at the corner. If you can see this. We have these two 15-0s at the corner, and I'm passing through these two together. I'm not adding any bead in between these two 15-0s. And now I'm going to add one 15-0 silver and pass through these two at the corner. So, like this. Again, picking up 150 nos silver and pass through the 250 nos at the corner. Again, picking up 150 nos silver and pass through the 250 nos at the corner. You can see the corner here that we created with these 11 nos. So I'm just passing through the 250 nos that we added at this corner. And now adding my last 50 no. And into the 250 nos at the corner. So after adding these 50 nos at the corner, this is the look. Stepping up into the first 50 no that we added in this round. Now, after stepping up into this first 50 no of this round, I'm going to pick up 150 no silver and pass through the second 50 no that we added in the last round. Again, picking up one more 50 no, passing through the third 50 no that we added in the last round. And in this last round, we are going to add 4 50 nos. So this is my third 50 no of this round. So here I have added 1, 2, 3 50 nos. And now I'm adding my last, that is the fourth 50 no of this round. Like this. And after adding the 4 50 nos, I'm stepping up into the first 50 no that I added in this round. And now I'm going to pass through all the 450 nos that I have just added in this last round and close my bezel case. So I'm taking 2 to 3 passes with these 4 beads, these 450 nos. Like this. Friends, here I would like to bring into your notice one more thing. There is a slight difference between the sizes of the same size of rivoli. There's a slight difference here. Both these rivolis are 10 mm in size, but this one is Preciosa and this is my local rivoli. And if you feel that you need to add this last round of 50 nos, if your rivoli is slightly bigger like this, you will definitely need to add this last row of 50 nos that I have added in this bezel case. But if the size of your rivoli is slightly smaller, the same size, that is a 10 mm rivoli, then you may not need to add this last row. The second last row will become your last row. So it depends upon the size of the rivoli that you are taking. If you really want to add this last row or not. If you don't find the space for adding this last row of 450 nos, then you can skip this round and close the bezel with this second last row of 450 nos that we have added in this bezel case. Now, after closing my bezel case, we are going to step up. So right now I'm exiting through this 50 no silver, stepping up into this 50 no. Into this 50 no at the corner, into the 50 no, into the 11 no, into the 11 no, into this 11 no, and into this 11 ohm. So here you can see we have reached the corner. You can see the corner here, and now we are going to add our pearls at this corner.
So I'm picking up one
3 mm pearl in burgundy color and passing through this next 11 o, picking up 1 11 o silver, passing through the next 11 o, again picking up 1 11 o silver, passing through this next 11 o aqua green, picking up 1 3 mm pearl, passing through the next 11 o. We have to add the pearls at the corner. Just check this. This is the corner. And now again, adding 11 o's. So here we have to add 2 11 o's and 1 pearl and 2 11 o's and 1 pearl in this round. And this way, we are going to complete this round and come back. And here I'm adding my last 11 o of this round. And this is the look after completing this round. And now, stepping up into the 3 mm pearl. Pick up 3 15 o silver and I'm passing through the 11 o just below this 11 o silver into these two 11 o dark metallic green iris into the 11 o aqua green, picking up 3 15 o silver and into the 3 mm pearl, stepping down into the 2 15 o silver out of the 3 that we added on this side, picking up 2 15 o silver and now stepping up into the second and third 15 o silver, skipping the first one and stepping into the top two 15 o's like this. Keep your thread nice and tight here and into the 3 mm pearl like this. Now into the 11 o aqua green and into the 11 o silver. And I'm going to pick up 3 15 o silver and pass through this next 11 o silver and 11 o aqua green like this. Again into the pearl, the 3 mm pearl. Again pick up 3 15 o silver down through this 11 o under the 11 o silver, into these two 11 o metallic dark green iris, up through this 11 o aqua green, pick up 3 15 o silver and pass through the 3 mm pearl. Like this, stepping down into the two 15 o's, the first two 15 o's, pick up 2 15 o silver, stepping up into the two 15 o's here, skipping the first one and into the second and third, into the 3 mm pearl. Again, we have to keep our thread nice and tight here. Like this, into the 11 o aqua green and 11 o silver, pick up 3 15 o silver and into the 11 o silver and 11 o aqua green like this, into the 3 mm pearl. Pick up 3 15 of silver down through this 11 of aqua green under the 11 of silver into these two 11 of metallic dark green iris up through the 11 of aqua green. Pick up 3 15 of silver into the 3 mm pearl. Down through the first 2 15-ohms. Pick up 2 15-oh silver. Up through the 2 15-ohms. Second and third. Like this. And into the 3 mm. Again, keep your thread nice and tight here. And this is the look of our first. There are top component of our blossom earring. And now after completing this, we are going to pass through these two 11 O's down through this 11 O into the 11 O into this 11 O into the 15 O 11 O and here I'm going to tie a knot a double knot into these beads a couple of 11 O's here like this. So here we have closed our top component, the upper component of our blossom earring, and now we are going to make the pieuté V's of the bottom. Now we are going to make our pieuté V's, and for this I'm using this white pearl as the stopper bead, and here I have brought this down towards the end of my thread and just tying a single knot. I won't be using this bead, this pearl in my project, it's just a stopper bead, otherwise all our 11 O's will fall out of the thread, so just to stop them. And now I'm going to pick up my 11 O's. So here I have picked up these 11 O's. The first one is in silver color, my first 11 O. Then I have picked up 5 pairs of these. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. 5 pairs of these 11 O's, 11 O aqua and 11 O metallic dark green iris. Now, after that, I have picked up the pair of 11 O silver. Now again I'm going to pick up these pairs of 11 O aqua and 11 O metallic dark green. Again 5 pairs. I'm bringing these down and now I'm picking up my 5 pairs. So here are my 5 pairs. Here after picking up the 11 O silver, I have started the pairs with this 11 O metallic iris, the reverse here, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 pairs, and now I'm going to pick up 1 11 O silver. Now you can see the 11 O's that I have picked up right now. Let us just go through these 11 O's once again. 1 11 O silver, then
11 o aqua green, 11 o metallic iris, 11 o aqua green, metallic green iris, 11 o aqua green, metallic green iris, and in this sequence I have picked up 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 pairs, then one pair of 11 o silver. Then I have reversed the sequence by starting with this 11 o metallic green, then 11 o aqua, 11 o metallic green, 11 o aqua. Again, in this sequence, I have picked up 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 pairs, and this 11 o silver. So, in all, I have picked up 24 beads. Let us count once again 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. 21, 22, 23, and 24. So these are 24 11 O's. You can take the single color also, but here I'm taking the colors in contrast. And now you can see right now I'm here at the end of this 11 O silver, and now I'm picking up one 11 O silver. And I'm skipping this 11 o silver and I'm passing through the 11 o aqua green. Like this. We have to keep our thread nice and tight here to get a nice finish. Like this. Now, after passing through this 11 o aqua green, I'm going to pick up one 11 o metallic dark green iris, which I'm going to place on the top of this 11 o metallic dark green iris. So here, after picking it up, I'm skipping this 11 o and passing through this next 11 o aqua green, like this. So you can see my 11 o dark green iris is sitting over the previous dark green iris. Again, I'm picking up one 11 o metallic dark green iris and passing through the next 11 o aqua green, skipping the dark green iris in between, like this. Again, picking up 11 o dark green iris. I'm passing through the 11 o aqua green. You can see by skipping the 11 o's in between, my new 11 o's are sitting on those ones which I have skipped while adding these 11 O's. So again, I'm picking up an 11 O metallic dark green iris, skipping the previous one and passing through the 11 O aqua green, like this. Here we have to keep our thread nice and tight. Again, picking up an 11 O metallic dark green iris, and now I'm passing through the 11 O silver. Like this. So here we have to create a V shape here. So we are going to create an angle here. So for this, we are going to use the herringbone stitch. So we are picking up two 11 O's, 11 O silver, the pair of 11 O silver, and I'm passing through this next 11 O silver. You can see exiting through this one and passing through the next one after picking up the 11 O. The pair of 11 O silver. Allow these to sit on the previous pair like this. And now I'm skipping this 11 O dark green iris and picking one 11 O, and again I'm passing through the 11 O aqua green like this. Again, picking up one 11 O dark green iris, skipping the previous one and passing through the 11 O aqua green. Again, picking up dark green iris and passing through this 11 O aqua green. Again, picking up 11 O dark green iris and passing through the 11 O aqua green. Again, picking up 11O dark green iris and passing through this 11O aqua green. Now, after exiting through this 11O aqua green, I have picked up 11O silver and I am flipping it up. And after flipping my component here, I am going to pass through this 11O silver very carefully, like this. So here you can see I have passed through this 11O silver, and now I'll be working on the inner side of this V component. And now here we have to add the bead on top of this 11O aqua green. So first of all, I'm going to add one 11O silver here. So I'm picking up an 11O silver and passing through the metallic dark green iris. And now I'm going to pick up an 11O aqua green into the metallic dark green iris. Again, picking up an 11O aqua green and into the metallic dark green iris. Picking up one 11O aqua green and passing through the 11O dark green iris. Picking up one 11O aqua green and passing through 11O dark green iris, like this. Now, after reaching this 11O dark green iris in the mid here, I'm going to pick up two 11O silver and pass through this 11O dark green iris. We have started this V on the other side also, on the inner side. And now I'm going to add 11O aqua green as we did on the other side, like this. Again, picking up one 11O aqua green into the 11O metallic dark green iris, picking up one 11O aqua green into the 11O dark green iris. Again, picking up one 11O aqua green and passing through this 11O dark green iris. And here, the last bead of this side, I'm going to add 11O silver, like this. And now, flip it up. And now, after exiting through this 11O, I'm picking up 215O silver, 13mm pearl, and 215O silver. Here I have picked up these five beads, 215Os, 13mm pearl, and 215Os. And I'm going to pass through this 11O silver. So here I have added these beads, like this. And now pick up an 11O silver and pass through this 11O metallic dark green iris. Now we have to add 11Os on the top of this, so we are going to add 11O aqua green. So again, picking up an 11O aqua green, again adding one 11O aqua green. Here again, I'm adding 11O aqua green. Again, adding 11O aqua green. Adding 11O aqua green. And now I'm going to pass through this 11O silver. And now I'm going to add the pair of 11O silver on the top of this. So I'm picking up two 11 of silver, a pair of 11 O's, and passing through the next 11 of silver. Allow these to sit properly, and like this. Again, picking up one 11 O, aqua green, like this. Now, adding this 11 O aqua green. Again, adding 11 O aqua green in this row till we reach this last 11 O. Adding 11 O aqua green, and here we have reached the last bead, and that will be our 11 O silver. Like this. And now I'm going to remove a stopper bead very gently and tie a knot. And here, so after tying this knot, just pull it toward the outer 11 O through which I exited just now. And now I'm going to pick up two 15 O's, one 3 mm pearl, and two 15 O's, the set of these 5 beads, and I'm going through the 11 O. We have to keep our thread nice and tight. Like this. And into the 11 O. And now we are going to work on the inner side of our V component. So here, after exiting through this 11 O silver, I'm again picking up an 11 O silver. The first bead would be 11 O silver, and now I'm going to add these 11 O metallic dark green iris. Again, picking up dark green iris. Again, picking up dark green iris. And here, after exiting through this 11 O aqua green, I'm going to pick up one 11 O dark green iris and into the 11 O silver on the other side. And now we are going to add the pair of 11 O silver on the top of this, like this. We are working on both the sides, the front and the back, simultaneously. So this is the inner side. And now again, picking up an 11 O metallic dark green iris and into the 11 O aqua, into the 11 O aqua. Again, picking up an 11 O metallic dark green iris and into the 11 O aqua. Again, into the 11 O aqua green. And now adding the last bead, which will be the 11 O silver. So here is 11 O silver. And now, after exiting through this 11 O silver, you can see after adding this last 11 O silver on this side, I'm not moving up into these 11 O's on the top. I'm just bringing the two ends together and I'm passing through the 11 O silver just in front of this. Here you can see I'm passing through this 11 O silver green bar thread nice and tight here. We are closing these two. We have started closing. So after exiting through this 11 of silver, again pick up an 11 of silver and pass through the next 11 of aqua green like this. Just keep it tight here. And now we have to add 11 O's in between 11 O aqua green. So we are going to add metallic dark green iris like this. Again, picking up an 11 O metallic dark green iris. Picking up an 11 O metallic dark green iris. Again, picking up an 11 O metallic dark green iris. Picking up an 11 O metallic dark green iris and into the 11 O silver. Now pick up a pair of 11 O silver. We're going to add on the top of this. Allow it to sit on this. And into. Now again picking up an 11 O metallic dark green iris and into the 11 O aqua green. Again 11 O metallic dark green iris into the 11 O aqua green. So we have to add these metallic dark green iris till we reach the last bead of this row, which will be our 11 of silver. So here we have reached the last bead of this side, and this will be our 11 of silver, and into these two 11 O's. This one again, not moving on the top. Yeah. Stepping down into the two 11 O silver on this side. Like this. So we have reached the inner side. Again, first bead is 11 O silver. And now we have to add 11 O aqua green. Okay, 11 O aqua green. Okay, 11 O aqua green. And here, a pair of 11 O silver. And again 11 O aqua green till I reach this last bead, which will be 11 O silver. Now I have added my 11 O aqua green, and now I'm adding my last bead of this row, which is 11 O silver, and I'm passing through this 11 O silver, and on the other side into the 11 O silver. Again, closing like this. We have to keep it nice and tight. Pick up one 11 O silver, which is my first bead on this side. And now I'm going to add 11 O aqua green in between these metallic dark green iris. So here I'm going to add 11 O aqua green and the pair of 11 O silver, then 11 O aqua green till I reach this last bead, which will be my 11 O silver. I will complete this and come back. So here I have added 11 O aqua green, and now I'm adding my pair of 11 O silver. in the middle like this, and now I'll be adding 11O aqua green like this. Now here, after adding these 11O aqua green, I'm adding my last bead on this side, which is my 11O silver like this. Now moving on to the other side into this, sorry, into this 11O. Like this, and stepping up into this 11O. Now again, my first bead will be 11O silver, and I have to add in between these 11O aqua green, so I am adding the other color, that is metallic dark green iris. So here I'm adding 11O metallic dark green iris, and I'll be adding these beads, then the pair of 11O silver in the middle, and then 11O metallic dark green iris, and the last 11O, that is 11O silver. So I'll complete this row and come back. Now after adding all my 11O metallic dark green iris, I'm adding my last bead, that is the 11O silver, and into 11O silver on this side. Again, picking up on 11O silver, adding the 11O silver, that is the first bead on this side, and now I'm adding 11O metallic dark green iris. Now, this is the last row on this side, so here we have a little variation. After adding this 11O metallic dark green iris on the top or in the middle, we have to add one 11O silver, not the pair, only single 11O silver, and like this. And now 11O metallic dark green iris, till we reach the end of this row. And here my last bead will be 11O silver like this, and now into the 11O silver in front of this, into the 11O silver. Now here you can see we have added 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 pairs of 11O silver on this side. Now after adding these 5 pairs of 11O silver on this side, now we are going to add this bead, that is 11O aqua green. Now here my first bead is not 11O silver, it will be 11O aqua green, and this will be the last row on the back side. So here I'm adding 11O aqua green, slight variation in the last row of both the sides. Now 11O silver, 11O aqua green, again adding 11O aqua green, and here we have added 1, 2, 3, 4 pairs of 11O silver, but we need to add 5. So this is our last pair, that is the 5th pair of 11O silver on this side. On the other side also, we added 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 pairs of 11O silver, and 6th was this single 11O. Now here, after adding the 5 pairs, so here I have to add 11 o aqua green. Till the end of this row. Now here again you can see we have added 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 pairs of 11 of silver. So here again I'm going to add 11 of aqua green as my last bead. And now into this 11 of silver. Now we have to close this component. So here after exiting through this 11 of silver on this side, I'm going to pass through this 11 of aqua green, then into the 11 of metallic dark green iris, into the 11 of aqua green, into 11 of metallic dark green iris. Here we are closing the component. You can see the look into 11 of aqua green, 11 of dark green iris, 11 o aqua green, 11 o dark green iris, 11 o aqua green, one from here and one from here, 11 o aqua green, sorry, 11 o metallic dark green iris, and now into the pair of 11 of silver, the first 11 of, and now into this single 11 of that we added on this side, and into the second 11 of silver on the other side, like this. You can see we have joined the two ends. And we have made a 3D V beauty with beauty stitch. And into, after exiting through this 11 of silver, into 11 of metallic dark green iris, 11 of aqua green. We have to keep our thread nice and tight here. Into 11 of metallic dark green iris, 11 of aqua green, and 11 of metallic dark green iris. Into 11 of aqua green. Metallic dark green iris. 11 of aqua green and into the 11 of metallic dark green iris, 11 of aqua green and into the 11 of silver on the other side. Here we have closed our V into the 11 of silver like this. So here our component is closed, and now after exiting through this 11 of silver, I'm moving through these, through this 11 of silver. Now after exiting through this 11 of silver, I'm picking up 115 of silver, 14 mm bodkin, and 115 of silver. So here I have picked up these three beads. And now into the 3 mm pearl like this. But before this, let us first cut the tail off. Very carefully. And now, after exiting through this 3 mm pearl, pick up 115 of silver into the bodkin, here again we have to keep our thread nice and tight, this. Again, pick up 1 15 of silver and pass through the 11 of silver like this. So here, after adding the python, you can see the look, and now we are going back into the beads. Into these two. This way we are reinforcing, and we have to reach the opposite side of this V, the other side. Like this. Into the 11 of silver, and now pick up 115 of silver, 14 mm bacon, and 115 of silver. These three beads. And into the 3 mm pearl. Again, pick up 115 of silver down through the python and 115 of silver into the 11 of silver. Like this. Here you can see the look, and now into we are moving towards the inner side of this V. So friends, here we have completed our first beauty V, and now I'm going to move on this 11O and I'm going to attach this to our upper component. So here right now I'm exiting through this 11O aqua green, and now I'm going to pass through this adjacent 11O into 11O dark green iris. Into 11O aqua green. Again into 11O dark green iris. Into 11O aqua green. Into 11O dark green iris, and into 11O aqua green. So here I'm exiting through this 11O aqua green, and now I'm going to attach it to my component, the upper component that we have made. Now after exiting through this 11O aqua green, I'm going to pick up 115 of silver, 14 mm bacon, and 115 of silver. So here I have picked up these three beads. Now after picking up our three beads, we are going to pick up our upper component, and we have to attach it this way by keeping this pearl, which is in the middle of the two sets of 15 O's that we have added on the two sides here. So this is the top of our upper component, and we have to keep attach it in this way to our POTV component. So here, after picking up the three beads, I'm going to pass through this 3 mm pearl. Like this. And now I'm going to pass through these 15 o's that I have added in front of this 3 mm pearl. Into these two 15 o's and into these two 15 o's. So here I have passed through all these 6 15 o's and down through the three beads that I have added just now, the 15 o, picon, and the 15 o. And into this 11 o aqua green. Like this. Moving up through the 15 o, picon, and 15 o. Into the 3 mm pearl. Into this 11 o aqua green and 11 o silver. Like this. 11 o aqua green and 11 o silver. Up to the first 15 o. Here you can see I have added 3 15 o's. So here I'm stepping up into the first 15 o, skipping the second one into the third 15 o, like this, into the 11 o silver next to 15 o silver, into 11 o aqua green, very carefully, into the 11 o aqua green. And do the 3 mm pearl like this. And now this is the top of our earring. So here I'm going to add my ear hook. Now here, after passing through this 3 mm pearl, I'm going to pick up 3 15 o silver. Bring them down. Here you can see I'm exiting through this pearl from this side. So very carefully here I have to add my ear hook. So this is the ear hook and this is the front side. So here I'm going to pass through this side of the ear hook and bring it down. Like this. And now picking up 3 15 o silver and pass through the 3 mm pearl like this. So here we have added the ear hook, and now I'm going to pass through all these 15 o's and the ear hook once again to reinforce. Into the 15 o's like this and into the 3 mm burr. So here we have attached the ear hook on the top, and now after exiting through this 3 mm burr, I'm going to pass through the next 11-0 aqua green and into the 11-0 silver, and into the next 15-0 silver. So you can see I am passing through 3 beads, 11-0 aqua green, 11-0 silver, and the first 15-0 silver. Like this, and skipping the second 15-0, I'm going to pass through the third 15-0 and into the next 11-0 silver and 11-0 aqua green. So here you can see I'm skipping the middle 15-0 and passing through the next 3 beads. Like this. And now into the 3 mm burr. So here, this is the look. We have attached the hook, and now we are exiting through this 3 mm burr on the other side. And now I'm going to attach it to the other side of our POJV, and here, after exiting through this 3 mm burr, again I'm picking up 1 15-0 silver, 1 4 mm bicon, and 1 15-0 silver, and pass through this 11-0 aqua green. Just visualize in between these two 11-0 silver. Like this. Going back into the 15-0 silver, bicon, and the 15-0 silver, like this. Keep your thread nice and tight here. Into the 3 mm pearl, and now into these 15-0s. Add it in front of the 3 mm pearl, these 6 15-0s, down through the 15-0, the bicon, and the 15-0, like this, and now into the 11-0 aqua green, into the 11-0 dark green iris, and into this next 11-0 aqua green. So here you can see we have attached the bicons on the two corners of this V, and the top component is attached. And now again, after exiting through this 11-0 aqua green, I'm picking up 1 15-0 silver, 1 4 mm bicon, and 1 15-0 silver. And now after picking up these 3 beads, I'm going to pass through the 11-0 silver. Here you can see this 11-0 silver, down through these 3 beads into the same 11-0 aqua green, and into the 11-0 metallic dark green iris. Like this. Gain into the next 11 o aqua green. Be careful, we have to add these pycons to these 11 o aqua green. It lies in the center here, 1, 2, and 3. So this is the third one. And now again, exiting through the 11 o aqua green, I'm picking up 115 o silver, 4 mm pycon, and 115 o silver. So these three beads. And now into this next 11 o silver on the upper component. Down through the 15 o silver, pycon and the 15 o silver into the 11 o aqua green and into the 11 o dark green iris. Like this. And now I'm going to pass through this 11 o aqua green into the 11 o dark green iris and 11 o aqua green, 11 o dark green iris, and into these 11 o silver at the center, the second 11 o silver. So here I'm exiting through this 11 o silver, and now I'm picking up 115 o silver, 111 o metallic dark green iris, 14 mm pycon, 111 o metallic dark green iris, and 215 o silver. So here I have picked up these beads, 115 o silver, 111 o metallic dark green iris, 4 mm pycon, 111 o dark metallic dark green iris, and 215 o silver, bringing these down. And now I'm passing through this pearl, the center pearl at the bottom of the upper component. Like this. Now picking up 215 o silver. So the 215 o silver into the 11 o pycon and the next 11 o. Like this. 115 o silver and into this 11 o silver. So here you can see we have attached the component from the center, and now into the 11 o silver, into the 11 o metallic dark green iris, into the 11 o aqua green, 11 o metallic dark green iris, and into 11 o aqua green, 11 o metallic dark green iris, and into the 11 o aqua green. Like this. So here I have reached the third 11 o, first, second, and third on the other end, and now I'm going to add the pycons here. So after exiting through this 11 o aqua green, I'm picking up 115 o silver, 14 mm pycon, and 115 o silver. These three beads and into the 11 o silver on the upper component. Down through these three beads into the 11 oh. Echo green. Into the 11-0 metallic dark green iris and into the 11-0 aqua green. Again, picking up the set of three beads, 15-0 silver, 4mm bicon, and 15-0 silver. And now passing through this next 11-0 silver on the upper component, like this, down through these three beads and into the 11-0 aqua green, like this. So here we have attached the upper component to our first BOT bead. Now here, after attaching my first BOT bead, right now I'm exiting through this 11-0 aqua green and now into the 11-0 aqua green, sorry, 11-0 metallic dark green iris, and in 11-0 aqua green into 11-0 silver, down through the 11-0 silver at the back, again into the 11-0 silver at the back, into 11-0, and into these two 11-0s. Here I'm going to tie a knot. A couple of plates. Again, tying a knot. And into these beads, and now I'm going to cut the thread off. So here I have attached my BOT bead with the upper component, and now I'm going to make my second BOT bead, and then I'll be attaching it to my earring. So let me first prepare my second BOT bead and come back. So friends, here I have completed my BOT bead, but I have not yet added the bicons on the two sides, and I have joined the two sides, the front and the back of this BOT bead. And after adding joining the two ends, right now you can see I'm exiting through this 11-0 aqua green, and now I'm stepping up into this 11-0 silver, and here I'm going to add the bicons. So right now, after exiting through this 11-0 silver, I'm going to pick up 115-0 silver, 14mm bicon, and 115-0 silver, these three beads, and pass through this, as I'm exiting through this 11-0 silver, so I'm going to pass through this side of the pearl like this, Again, picking up 115 of silver down through the beacon like this. Picking up 115 of silver and down through this 11 of silver, the last one. So here you can see I have attached the beacon on the side of the beauty V, and I'm going down through this 11 of aqua green, 11 of metallic dark green iris, 11 of aqua green, 11 of metallic dark green iris, 11 of aqua green, 11 of metallic dark green iris. These are the beads which I have joined just now. So I'm just reinforcing the thread in this way, and we are going down while passing through these 11 of aqua green and 11 of metallic dark green iris. Now into the 11 of metallic dark green iris, into this 11 of silver, into this middle 11 of silver. And now here I'm going to add my drop bead. So for this I'm going to pick up, so these are my beads that I'm going to add as drops. So this is 11 of silver, 4 mm beacon, my drop bead, and 11 of silver. And now I'm bringing them down towards the end of the thread near the B component, and going back, skipping the 11 of silver, going back through the drop bead, beacon, and the 11 of silver like this, into the 11 of silver, just taking one more pass through these beads just to reinforce. Into these beads, and into the 11 of silver like this. So we have added the drop bead here, and now after exiting through this 11 of silver, into the 11 of silver, into this 11 of metallic dark green iris, 11 of aqua green, 11 of metallic dark green iris, and 11 of aqua green, 11 of metallic dark green iris, and 11 of aqua green, came into 11 of metallic dark green iris, and 11 of aqua green, and 11 of metallic dark green iris, and 11 of aqua green. So here I have reached this middle 11 of aqua green, into the 11 of silver. Now picking up 115 of silver, 4 mm beacon, and 115 of silver, the three beads, and here I'm exiting through this 11 of, so into the pearl through this side like this, picking up 115 of silver down through the beacon, again picking up 115 of silver down through the 11 of silver like this, into the 11 of aqua green, and 11 of metallic dark green iris. So here we have completed our V and added the drop. And now I'm going to attach it to my earring. So right now I'm exiting through this 11O metallic dark green iris. And now I'll pass through this 11O metallic dark green iris, 11O aqua green, and 11O metallic dark green iris, 11O aqua green, and 11O metallic dark green iris, and into the 11O aqua green, the center one here. And now I'm going to attach it to my earring. So now I'm going to pick up 115O silver, 14mm pipe pin, and 115O silver. So I have picked up these three beads, bringing these down, picking up my earring. And now you can see I'm going to attach it to these here. Right now I'm exiting through this 11O aqua green in the bottom V component, and now I'm going to attach these to these middle 11O's metallic dark green iris. So here on the upper component I'm going to use these middle 11O metallic dark green iris, taking from the bottom side here. So I'm going to use 1, 2, 3, these three 11O's from the bottom. So I'm adding the beacon on the top of the on the top 11O of the bottom component, and I will be adding it to this 1, 2, 3, this 11O metallic dark green iris on the upper component like this. Down through these three beads like this into the 11O aqua green like this. So here you can see we have attached our beads here. Now up through these three beads and into the 11O metallic dark green iris, to which we have added the beads, into the 11O aqua green, and the next 11O metallic dark green iris. And now after exiting through the second 11O, I'm going to pick up 115O silver, 4mm beacon, and 115O silver. Again, the set of these three beads. And here at the bottom component, I'm going to add these to the second 11O aqua green. Like this. Up through the three beads and down and into the 11O metallic dark green iris, to which I have added these beads. You have to keep the thread nice and tight, and into the 11O aqua green. This into the 11O metallic dark green iris, now here I'm exiting through the third 11O metallic dark green iris, and now again I'm going to pick up the set of same three beads, 15O 4mm beacon and 15O silver, and into this 11O aqua green at the bottom, the third one in this row. Up through these three beads into the 11 or metallic dark green iris, into the 11 or silver, into the middle 11 or silver of the top component, and now I have picked up these beads, 215 or silver, 111 or metallic dark green iris, 4 mm bacon, 111 or metallic dark green iris, and 215 or silver. And as I'm exiting through this 11 or silver, I'm exiting through this side, so I'm going to pass through this 11 or silver in the bottom V component. Up to this next 11 or silver. Now picking up to 15 or silver, up through the 11 or metallic dark green iris, the pipekin, and the next 11 or like this, picking up to 15 or silver, and into the 11 o silver like this, so here we have added the center beads, and now into the 11 o silver, into the 11 o metallic dark green iris, and now we are going to add the bikers on this side as we have added on the previous one. So here again, I'm picking up 115 or silver, 14 mm bacon, and 115 or silver, these three beads. And as I'm exiting through this bottom 11 o, I'm going to pass through the third 1, 2, 3, the third 11 o aqua green. Be careful, we have to add to this row, the middle one, from the top and from the bottom. From the bottom also and from the top also. So into the third 11 o aqua green, up through the three beads, into this 11 o metallic dark green iris, 11 o aqua green, and into the 11 o metallic dark green iris, like this. So again, pick up 115 o silver, 14 mm bacon, and 115 o silver, the set of same three beads, and into the second 11 o aqua green. At the bottom component, up through the same three beads, into the metallic dark green iris, into the 11 o aqua green, and into the next metallic dark green iris. Again, picking up the last set of three beads, 15 o 4 mm bacon, and 15 o silver, and down through this 11 o aqua green, up to these three beads, into this 11 o metallic dark green iris. So here you can see we have added these beads, and right now I'm exiting through to this 11O metallic dark green iris. So I'm going to pass through this 11O aqua green at the back into 11O metallic dark green iris, 11O aqua green, and here I'm going to tie a knot into the 11O metallic dark green iris, into 11O aqua green, into 11O metallic dark green iris, back into the adjacent 11O metallic dark green iris, just taking passes through some of the beads. Again, tying a knot into these 11O metallic dark green iris. Eleven O aqua green, 11O metallic dark green iris, and 11O aqua green. So after passing through these couple of beads, I'm cutting my thread off. So friends, here we have completed our blossom earring in this gorgeous amethyst and green contrast. Friends, if you decrease the length of this earring as I have done in this pink blossom earring, what you have to do is just add the top component with the bottom one. Here, just add this top component to this bottom component and just skip the middle one. So you will get this size of our blossom earring. So let us take a quick look over the earrings that I have made. I have made these long danglers in two colorways. This one is in amethyst and sea green color, and the other one is amethyst and emerald green color. And the two colorways in the smaller size by adding this V, the single V here. This one is in pink color and the other one in this sapphire color. So friends, I hope you would love these danglers, these long and these small danglers, the blossom earrings, and they are going to complement your ethnic wear as well as your Western wear. And I hope you would enjoy making these beautiful, these gorgeous earrings and wear it with your different wears, different attires, and of course, gifting it to your friends and families. So friend, if you like my designs and my tutorials, please do subscribe to my channel, and please don't forget to press the bell icon so that you may get notified when I'll upload my next video. Thank you and namaste.